Church, as we continue our journey of teaching and equipping the believers and members of Cape Charles Baptist Church, we are encouraging you to grow in your faith and strengthen your relationship with Christ and with each other in service. Today, we'll discuss stewardship and fully understand our purpose as servant leaders in God's kingdom now. In Christ, you have an entitlement. Paul says, all things are yours, and you are of Christ, and Christ is of God. We have all things because we are united to Christ and Christ with God the Father. But we don't have ownership. We belong to God, and everything we possess belongs to Him. We are stewards of the mysteries of God, the truth that has been revealed in the gospel, our Lord Jesus Christ. A steward is someone who manages a household or an estate. Now it is required that those who have been given a trust must prove faithful. The use of your own lives and all that we possess has been entrusted to us, and someday we'll give an account for how well we have managed the estate. There is no time that is ours, and the rest is God. There is no portion of money that is ours, and the rest belongs to God. All belongs to Him. He made it all and simply entrusted us for His service. Jesus told another parable about a rich fool. The man who produced such a good crop that he had to tear down his barns and build bigger ones. Thinking that he had stored up enough to last many years, he decided to take it easy, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, "You fool! This is very night your life will be demanded from you. Then, who will get what you have prepared for yourself?" On another occasion, a rich young man asked Jesus how he could get eternal life. Jesus told him to keep the commandments. The rich man said that he already did. Then Jesus said, "If you want to be perfect, go, sell all your possessions, and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me." The young man walked away because he had great wealth. Jesus showed the rich young man that his righteousness was self-righteous and that his security was in his possessions and not in his internal relationship with God. You may say to yourself, "My power and the strength of my hands have produced this wealth for me." But remember the Lord your God, for he gives you the ability to produce wealth. It is not just the result of our labor that we are called to be stewards, but the labor given us time, talent, and treasure, which remains his property, but we are intended to be used for his glory, to glorify Him. So we make it our goal to please Him, whether at home, in the body, or away from it. For we must all appear before judgment seat of Christ, that each one may receive what is due him for the things while in the body, whether good or bad. Since then, we know what it is to fear the Lord. We try to persuade men. Thought for the day. Why and what are we persuading people to do? I'm trying to enlist the assistance of the congregation for when we do finally return to the building. I hope this video convicts you to the core and allows you to examine the gifts that the Lord has given you to share with others. As always, blessings.